We're back.
Yeah, yes we are.
So the first 45 minutes, we got betrayed by our country, we betrayed our country, and we got a mountain dropped on our heads, and somewhere along the line, Kane's gone.
He went somewhere. Yeah. There we go, party. Okay. I am solo for a bit.
She might be unconscious. I don't think you want her to be fighting right now.
A tiny bit unconscious. No, I'm just gonna run. It seems like the best choice. Actually, I'm pretty beefy.
Yes.
We call this solo grinding.
No, don't do it.
No, oh my god, actually they are outpacing me pretty quickly. Keep going for it. Oh, that's...
Running can be a little hard. You can also just heal yourself up real quick.
Yeah.
A potion. Yeah, some of the character thoughts are decent. Sometimes, though, you're just thinking, oh, geez, I didn't need to, like, know that. Or at the same time, wow, thanks for the contribution. A plus.
Speaking of which, what is Cecil thought right now?
Eh.
Nah. Very upset at the fact that he orphaned a child. To be fair, it's a pretty legit thing to be distressed about. Okay, yes, the location of Desert Town is a mystery to us currently. Probably by this oasis. Yep, I did not even need to heal. Kaipo.
Eh.
Oh, alright, we're on rails. Thank you for the contribution there, auto walk.
I need to find the inn. What inn? You mean that inn right there? Yeah, I'm going to walk you there. No.
Oh, right. We sleep for free because we have a child.
I wonder how much extra money Cecil has to pay to stay at an inn, because all his armor would rip up the sheets and the bedding and everything.
It's my understanding that he probably takes the armor off, but yes, the exoskeleton.
With the pointy bits and such.
Yeah. You should find a good picture of the exoskeleton and put that in the chat.
I will look around.
It won't. It's not like a hitbox that won't post, but yes, people can open the picture just to see what it's supposed to look like. Oh, right, this is a boss fight.
Yeah, by the way, it's a boss fight.
I should have probably saved.
Eh, you're fine.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Take out two of the three guardsmen, and then kill the guy in the back.
Alright.
Otherwise, he ditches, and that's experience lost, and why would you do such?
Should I darkness before I go for him? Probably.
Yes, it just speeds it up. They're hitting for 8. Ha 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 ha.
Luckily, I got that level.
It's almost like these guys are chumps and you're a hardened, seasoned warrior.
It's almost as like I'm the elite of the Baron forces and they're not.
Yep.
Oh, okay, I see how darkness works. It's every attack that I do. It's not a cast. Because in Super Nintendo, it was like... What? The soldier gets super confused.
Yep, doesn't have anyone to order him around.
In the Super Nintendo version, it was like an AoE, right?
Yeah, it's a dark pulse wave kind of thing. And it removes 1/8 of your health to do it, I think. It's either 1/8 or 1/16.
Probably 1/16.
It's an a not insubstantial amount. But in the process of doing it, you hit the whole screen for pretty much an auto attack's worth of damage. But it's really useful for clearing out a bunch of enemies.
Maybe a bit too useful early on in the game, so that's probably why they changed it.
Actually, they removed a bunch of the different commands because I think they thought that Americans wouldn't be able to navigate the game with all the extra stuff.
Huh.
Yeah. Americans got the, like I said, game for babies version.
Apprentice Summoner. I didn't need to sleep again, probably. My initial thought was, I just got out of a fight. I should probably sleep.
You took like 80 damage, and most of that was self-dealt.
Alright, so.
Besides, Rydia's useful.
Here's Rydia. She can do a whole lot of nothing right now. I went to the magic menu. She has Cure, Sight, Hold. How do I change?
So, this is actually one of the few changes they made in this game. Rydia comes at a higher level than she does in the original.
Right, which is a bit of a ruined thing, a point I was going to make. But anyway, she comes Cure, Sight, Hold, Blizzard, Thunder, Chocobo. Hold does paralysis. Simple magic. So, it really what that is, her coming at a higher level just saves you some time. You don't have to grind her up, which is nice. It's a good quality of life thing. The touch that we miss out on because of that. Taking a deep breath here. So, Final Fantasy is, of course, sort of loosely based off of D&D. Mechanics and everything like that. Just, your standard role-playing stuff. And Rydia, as a young child that has never had to fight, originally comes in at level 1, which makes sense. As such, as she's gaining her first couple of levels, she actually gains HP at an extreme rate, like really, really fast. It's because the original definition of HP is hit points, as in it's the number of hits you can take before you take a mortal wound. So the implication here in her getting a lot of HP really fast is it is Cecil teaching her how to fight.
Yep. Because Cecil is a seasoned hardened warrior and she...
Exactly.
Also something different in this game is a lot of characters come with better gear than they did in the original. You'll see this more and more as the game goes on, but some characters come with gear that's either equal to what you can buy in town or better. In the original game, characters usually came with okay-ish gear, but by the time you got to the next town, you could either completely outfit them with better stuff or at least give them a couple upgrades. Riddy here, all she needed to have the best stuff available in town was a new hat. And that's it.
Yeah. I don't like how magic weapons don't show you the magic they have on them. They only show you the attack.
Yeah, well, all the rod does is magic missile, which is useful.
But it does give her plus one intellect, which is the important thing. Though, if I wonder healing, maybe a staff actually is better.
The rod lets her just spam an attack that allows her to deal a little bit of damage.
Fair.
Besides, you have plenty of potions anyway. The only thing I would suggest buying at this point are a couple Phoenix Sounds and calling it a day.
Hello. Large Chocobo. Oh,
by the way, you need to go to the top right of town.
Okay. Is that the dancer?
No. You need to go in the house at the top right of town. Yeah, that's a giant bird. I forgot he was there.
Ah, hello, Namiway. I love this continuing saga of you screwing up Naming Way's life.
He deserves it.
Living Way. in, you know, your bestiary, you can look over various things of monsters that you fought. There's no way to move through this quickly, is there?
Nope.
Ugh. It's awful, actually.
I had forgotten about that part and would just said, don't do it.
Anywho. Is that it? We just talked to him once?
Nope, keep walking in further into the building.
Oh, hello.
Yeah. If you wander around town, someone says some girl from Baron wandered in and she's being taken care of.
Ah, our first augment. We have to do social media again. I'm terrible at this.
Oh boy, the augment system. So the augment system is brand new for the DS version compared to all the other ones because they wanted to add even more complexity to the game. You can get some really cool stuff as the game goes along, but for the very beginning of the game, most of the stuff is pretty simple stuff. Auto potion augments exactly what it sounds like. You get hit, there's a chance you drop a potion on yourself to heal up. In the early part of the game here, it's very powerful. After about an hour, it is not powerful.
Now, unfortunately, there is a gimmick to the augment system of using it on characters who leave your party. As such, we're not using auto potion yet.
Nope, that's going to go to someone we'll meet an hour and a half-ish from now.
And the naming way here is just explaining augments.
Yeah.
Sorry. Advance through that dialogue quickly. You said get a couple Phoenix Downs, right?
Just be on the safe side.
Yeah, I can buy two.
Even though Rydia there is much more durable than she is when you originally get her in the SNES version, she's still a squishy mage.
Yep. Let me just make sure.
Yes, we do have an FAQ at hand to make sure we don't miss any. Most of the ones that are missable are later on in the game, so it won't be an issue this session, but it's nice to have one on hand, just be on the safe side.
Yes, and I do have I'm loosely following a walkthrough just to be like, hey, because I glanced through the walkthrough and it did have moments of, hey, you should go back to X and get that augment.
Most of the time after certain boss fights happen, which is just great.
Let's utilize our multiple slots here. Alright, so, current goal, locate a place in the forest. The forest of the land.
Yes. You're not helping yourself here.
Alright, so, how, did you just attack and she uses it like that?
You select it as an item.
Oh.
You want to go to the top right, by the way. Always top right.
Does it have to be...
If you go to the equipment menu and then like the items menu and then you press like up or something, it'll go to it. I forget how it works.
All right, that isn't it. Don't worry, people. We'll figure this out.
I think I figured or remembered how you do it. You just finish this fight first.
Okay.
I think you have to put in the command to do it on the action bar thing. Like, you can move around what skills you have available on your character, and you can move one of them to using the special ability of the rod.
You can, in fact, not switch around augments, and that's why it's so important to do them somewhat properly. Okay. Abilities, Rydia.
Like magic arrow or something like that.
I don't see it.
I know you have to select one of those abilities and you can switch it out with something. Oh, crap. Why is it not on there? Meh. You'll be fine without it. Just use lots of thunder.
All right, so you said up and to the right?
Yeah. There's a cave. Walk in the cave. Have fun in the cave.
They really hate Rydia.
Yes. Well, let's put it this way. If you were attacking people in the desert, and you saw a guy in full plate armor, some 10-ish-year-old person, which one would you hit?
Nice almighty. Also, thunder is not cheap.
No, it costs 5. Most of the enemies in the desert you should probably be hitting with ice, by the way. Forgot about that. Or you can just let her defend and let Cecil take care of business.
Should remember that she does actually have a cure spell.
Yeah. She's not super great with it. It's okay. You're about to meet someone who helps out with that.
Yes, Blizzard is...
I think you went a little bit too far to the right, by the way.
Significantly better.
There's a little pass, like north and a little bit to the right of Kaipo, into the mountains, and that is what where you need to go.
Confuse and sleep.
The question in the chat. So they're confused between this one and the other one with Cecil. And is this version a prequel to the other one? Okay, so the other one is a sequel to this.
Also, thank you for the follow.
Yeah, because that's the After Years, and the After Years is a thing. Horrible, horrible thing.
See if we're better off using her cure. Yeah, a potion is better than her cure.
I don't know if I got that. I give the After Years a lot of a hard time. It was a good idea, and there were some good things in there, but the execution was really bad.
Where are these tiny men?
They're adorable little guys that you should only be hitting with Cecil.
Holy shit.
Are you getting wrecked?
The difficulty has caught up to me. Oh, okay, they didn't go for Rydia. Rydia, use potions.
Now, the good thing about these tiny little mages is they give oodles of experience.
Good. I need it. Yeah, Rydia has leveled up twice. Every bit of HP she gets, I am extremely happy about.
Now, notice that even though she is gaining levels here and some HP, she's not gaining nearly as much HP per level as Cecil is. Because she's a squishy backliner and he is a tank.
I feel like I'm going the correct way. But I also feel like I get another party member.
If you go to the left, you do very quickly, actually. If you go to the left, you'll meet the new party member.
I saw him in the battle swirl.
Yeah, he's very close. And he lives up to his name here in this game.
Where do you know?
If it makes you feel better, the person you're about to meet can make you stand back up. I love these mages.
Why are they so rude?
Are you gonna die?
No. Wait, actually, no, I'm not. New party members by a save point, right?
No, you can walk back outside. You can just go back to town.
I don't know if I can get out of this dungeon without dying.
With a new party member?
You, get in my party.
Yeah, Tellah's... Spoilers, it's Tellah.
Tellah's great. I like that he's just like, ah, Anna's your daughter, then you must be Tellah. How do you know that? Like, how?
Once again, it's assumed that you're talking to people in town. Because Tellah's from Kaipo.
Okay.
So you're supposed to be walking around and be like, oh man, the sage Tellah's around here, but he ran after this nefarious bard that was in town that kidnapped his daughter, Anna.
I like,
we're streamlining this game, so we don't deal with that garbage.
I like that Tellah is actually like a right proper sage, in that one look at Rydia is like, ah, she's gonna do something great one day. Her magic potential is ridiculous. Okay, first things first, Rydia up. And everybody back to full health. Fantastic.
Yeah, Tellah, welcome to the party.
We have recovered the difficulty curve. I forgot you can multi-target magic.
Yes.
Why have you not told me? Why have you not corrected me on this yet?
I was laughing too hard. Also, until this point in where you got Tellah, didn't need it.
I could have been wiping out the desert encounters in one cast.
No, Rydia's magic is so low that she wouldn't actually do it. Are you dealing with mages again?
No, it's worse. I'm just gonna go out and use a tent. Counter re-raise? I'm sorry, what? You're dying first.
Yes, you zap him with lightning. Most of the enemies in this cave are actually weak to lightning.
Alright, if we utilize Rydia's magic to heal, we might actually just be able to make it back to the town. I don't have to use a tent.
Yeah. So, in the original game when you got Tellah, Tellah was pretty good. His magic could take care of some stuff, but really it was Cecil that was doing the heavy lifting in the game. That is not the case in this one. Tellah is going to do work.
Thanks to that cutscene, I know exactly where the inn is.
Uh-huh. Yeah, pretty much all Tellah needs to get in and out of this cave is someone to soak up hits, and hey, guess what? That's you.
Yep, just... Ah, I had to go get my daughter. Whoops, forgot my bones are made of nothing.
Mm-hmm. My bones are hollow now. They're so frail. So I need someone... Hey, look, there's this guy in full plate armor. He can take some hits for me.
I actually very much like... I don't know, because it doesn't happen as much anymore with the main characters of... I don't know where I'm going with this, but like, the main characters of Final Fantasy games have kind of moved away from being knights.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try and recall some magic.
Oh, good. I love this mechanic.
Alright, fire! You already know that.
So the recall
mechanic...
Holy
shit!
What?
I don't know if that's just Tellah or if that's recall.
It's Tellah.
But, like, fire should not be hitting for that much.
No. He was doing about 150 damage to all the enemies inside the cave with that lightning spell.
Alright, Tellah. Welcome to the fucking party.
Like I said, he just need tank.
Yeah, okay, his single target ice did 450 damage. Hello, Tellah. You can learn something from him, Meridia.
Yes.
Meridia, your int really needs to start going up every time you level.
It won't.
Don't say that. Why you gotta be like that?
Remember, she's learning.
Learn faster. Okay.
Her big thing that she's bringing to the party right now is that her utility. Once she starts getting up there in levels later on, she'll get access to a lot of other stuff.
Oh, hello.
Just about anything you meet in this cave, the correct answer is lightning.
Yeah. Now that I remember that you can multi-target.
Yeah, I think there is a way to check underneath that waterfall there to the right. If you wander around to the right.
God. It wasn't even worth the 3 mana. I do think I will keep Rydia on heal duty and just have Tellah nuke everything.
I wouldn't even worry about Rydia casting healing spells in combat. Just have her defend and heal outside.
Yeah, that's kind of what I meant. Just didn't articulate it well.
Sword. Yeah,
you have to... Is this the right... This is the right way. Bridge is right way. Up is wrong way.
If you go, keep going directly up in the top left corner of the map, that's the way to the next level.
God damn it.
But one of those two waterfalls you can walk into.
Right. I sort of actually remember that. Because you go down into the... I may actually need to turn down battle speed now.
Yeah, you've got so many people.
And I actually have to use commands other than attack.
Other than just hit them.
So yeah, let's turn down the battle speed a little bit. Probably back to the default.
Mm-hmm. Go with three.
Gonna go to default just for now.
Okay.
Right, because here it is. You go under that, and then up here there's a chest.
I think there's also a chest in the top right corner. Unless you already went there. Never mind. Oh man, look at all those mages.
Ah, hello. Get zorded. Oh, Tellah, this cave was a nightmare before you. How quickly this cave goes from extremely threatening to kind of threatening.
You only have another 13 shots of lightning before you, or excuse me, thunder, before you have to use an ether, though, so keep that one in mind.
What's a tensor for?
Huh. Secret place.
Secret.
Yep. Secret to everybody.
That was last night.
My apologies.
Yeah, she got int. Dry ethers are just a bigger heal?
They're a bigger ether.
A bigger, better ether.
Yes.
It's because they're dry. Good. Probably save that for a rainy day. Let's top everybody off. Everybody's about to that health amount where Rydia's cure won't top them off all the way. More tiny men.
So, a fun thing about Tellah, which I hope you know what, I'll wait for the next level and then we'll see if it happens or not.
So my mind's kind of messed up with Record Keeper mechanics. You can't defend spells, right?
No, Rydia was defending and taking half damage from spells earlier.
Okay.
Either that or her magic defense got crazy high.
Well, I mean, because that kind of, there's nothing up here.
Yeah, you already got everything from the up top right, I think.
Why does that exist?
Because?
For me to have to fill out map, that's what.
Yeah, I think there actually is a decent reward from one of these levels in here.
South, eye drops.
Not this level.
Yeah, we had problems with eye drops before. Every fight, Tellah casts thunder. Yep, there it is. Now it's happening.
The good stuff?
Yep, Tellah leveled up. So Tellah's old. That's the best way to describe it. When he levels up, he'll actually lose some stats like strength. The more athletic stats, he'll actually lose. He'll never lose HP. Thank God.
No, his HP will always go up a little bit. You'll notice, though, that his MP didn't go up. It stayed at 90. But every level, he'll probably lose one of his strength, speed, or stamina stats, but he'll almost always gain intelligence and spirit. So he hits really hard with his magic, but don't expect him to do anything else.
Yep. It's a dump stat. He got to, like, his max level, so now whenever he levels up, he can just reallocate stats.
Mm-hmm.
There's actually a very important plot point to why his magic MP doesn't go up.
Tellah's not the only character who can lose a stat point by leveling up, though. Cecil also can.
Really? Which one?
Will.
Huh.
It's tied to his armor.
That's fair. I've been thinking about this. You know, that's fine. It's fine. Yes. Oh!
What's up? Yeah, you can just set a spell.
Huh.
Maybe that's how you can... Oh, go through items. Maybe that's how you do the thing, because there was a staff command there. I saw it.
Okay.
Tellah's thing. You saw it too, right?
Yeah.
So switch Rydia's attack command to using the rod.
Yep, I can do that.
There it is. All right.
Wow, what a fucking stupid way to have to do that.
Yes. Yes, that is correct. So, Tellah's recall, because we showed it once, but that was pretty much it. Tellah's old. It's pretty much how we're going to describe most of the reasons how his mechanics work. So he doesn't remember all his magic. So because of that, you can press the recall command and he tries to remember one of the spells that he's forgotten because he's old. In the process of doing that, you have a small chance of getting, or you have a pretty large chance of casting one of the spells he already knows how to cast. You missed a chest, by the way. You need to go head back up north.
Okay.
You're already heading there.
No, I'm not actually, but noted.
Yeah, you were walking up the steps. That was a good way to do it.
Yeah, there you go, Mage Arrows. That does an attack worth of damage.
If he doesn't recall, he also has a smaller chance to cast a Fandara or a Fira or a Blizzara spell. He has also a smaller chance of casting Blizzaga, Fandaga, or Firaga. And he also has a small chance of casting some other really powerful spells. Like, he can cast Death. But not only can he cast Death, but he can cast Death on an AoE, which is the only way you can do it, is through the Recall mechanic. So it is possible for Recall to do some really crazy stuff, but most of the time, it's just going to cast a fire spell.
I got a Chivo, I think, for hitting level 15.
Congratulations.
Yeah, there's nothing up here. Except for that chest. You said up and to the right?
No. I meant for you to go up to where you are right now, actually, and check around there.
Oh, okay.
You need to circle around to the bottom left from here. You'll find a place where you can use a tent.
Back when... In an era where Final Fantasy games were pretty good about giving you save points right before bosses.
Oh, you're nowhere close to the boss. This is the halfway through the dungeon save point.
Save points when you need them.
Yes.
Yeah, she got in the end. And she knows Cura.
Mm-hmm.
I got another Chivo for, I guess, killing a bunch of monsters, because it's called Bronze Hunter.
Wow. So, here's a fun thing about Rydia that doesn't actually show up. She's one of the characters that has the best chance of gaining every stat and a level.
Are stat-ups randomized?
Kind of.
Ugh.
Characters have... certain stats that they're almost always going to have work, though. Like, Rydia's... Well, not... At this point, Rydia's probably going to start gaining intelligence with every level, because that's her, like, thing that she does. And Tellah's almost always going to gain intelligence and spirit.
Holy shit, I got an accessory.
What'd you get?
I got
Did you get a silver armlet? Yeah. Those guys have a small chance of dropping those.
Oh, that's... Okay, it's irritating. Alright. And you can't equip that. You, however, can. That gives you a lot of good stuff.
Yeah, so, fun fact, Rydia just comes with a silver armlet.
Good.
That's far better than what she should have.
Yeah, so you know, Tellah came with an iron one.
Mm-hmm. But Tellah came with Gaia gear, which is much more powerful than what he should have. Also, he doesn't wear a hat right now. Why? Because he's cool.
He doesn't have a hat on. Just like how Rydia
exactly.
Didn't have a hat on.
Yeah, you gave her a hat.
Oh, team's coming together. We actually hold our own.
Yeah, at the beginning of this dungeon, it was, oh, what are we going to do? Then he met Tellah. Suddenly, things started working.
Cecil's sitting there going, you know what? Maybe life isn't so bad. I got a kid and a grandpa.
Yeah. My girlfriend's dying from desert fever. My best friend got hit by a mountain. You know, it's all right.
My girlfriend's dying from desert malaria.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, let's just do an AoE Cura. That should take care of everyone.
Yep. If she casts AoE Cura spells at this point, it should make up for her spirit deficiency and do a decent amount.
Is Cura 9?
Yes.
Alright, so it just pays off. Because it cures for her cure, but AoE.
Yes.
Oh. The encounter rates feel a little high.
They are.
Magic is just so strong right now, it just doesn't really feel like much of a reason to do anything else but just AoE Thunder each turn.
You're right. There isn't a better option for right now. Remember, this is like your first dungeon that you're dealing with, so the game doesn't want to wreck you completely. So once you figured out, boy, I should use magic. Magic is the answer to everything in this dungeon.
Could've
because you have Tellah.
I do like learning the little things about how the engine works is making this way easier already, like the replacing commands and everything, items being castable.
Well, items were always castable.
I know, I didn't know that. Nothing in the game tells you that.
Yeah.
Ah, this is what they call a save point.
Yeah.
No.
Let's put on the let's talk to the party hat and break the fourth wall, perhaps.
Oh, he gives you a free tent.
Yep.
My daughter ditched me.
A little artwork for these guys.
I just love that they call it desert fever.
Yeah, you got the fever. It totally doesn't become a plot point in the after years.
What, desert fever?
Yeah.
Oh boy. After years just treads everything again, doesn't it?
Yes, yes it does. It even treads things that weren't a thing in the first place. It's just to pad out some stuff.
I remember the revelation during Last Fiesta of the tutorial message you get for hitting a save point isn't actually tied to the first save point. You just get it on the first save point you step on.
Yep.
Because I think for me that was like in the ghost ship or something. An ice rod.
Yep.
Radio, you're leveling up.
In Final Fantasy VI, it's the same deal. It's the first save point you step on. And most people step on it right when you walk into Narsh. But you can actually, if you're like skipping the save points, you don't have to get it all the way until you're going down the rapids.
Hey,
so it's one of those,
ice.
Dude, why haven't you been paying attention to this? Yeah, you can cast ice now as opposed to magic arrows.
Alright, so map 2 is 5 antidotes.
I think the next one gives you something a bit better.
We will see.
Also, 5 antidotes is nothing to sneeze at when enemies start poisoning you.
Right. I don't look down free status healing items. Nah, she cannot AoE her rod.
Meh.
Oh. These guys cast Toad.
Oh, you met the Toads.
I met the Toads.
I think the Toads are weak to ice.
They are, in fact, weak to ice, which is really nice that they just gave me that ice rod. I can't cast Frog.
Can use a Maiden's Kiss, however.
Haha, no effect on Cecil. He is too evil for your Frog magic.
I actually think his shield blocks it.
Thank God.
Which was not the case in the original game.
I believe Rydia has a Suna, though.
She might.
Just to save some stuff for battles.
Sage Tellah, Toadified.
Left or right at this fork?
You want to be heading downish.
Okay, so left
start.
Is the correct way. As in, it's the way I want to go for treasure. You are wrong.
Yes. I don't remember.
You have to go up.
Dang it. My knowledge.
Your smarts. No.
I said downish, you jerk.
Yeah, and then I went uppish.
Uh-huh.
Oh, and now Iridia can toad.
Yes, of course. So original, and again, we're going to play, I'm going to do a lot of this in the original game business because that's what I remember. Iridia doesn't usually get toad until the next dungeon or so, maybe the dungeon after that, because in this game, you gain levels a lot faster.
Tents. Three tents for the map.
There you go. That's actually useful because I don't think you had any. Or if you did have one, you only had a single one.
I believe the... something. I want to say Baron Castle gave me a tent.
Yeah, probably. That bomb fragment you picked up, and also the red fang you have in your inventory, are usable items that cast a certain spell. The red fang you have in your inventory from the opening cutscene, because in the original game, Cecil actually uses a red fang against those flying guys when they attack, because you don't have control. So you actually have a very powerful item in your inventory that you can break out when you need to.
I will keep that in mind.
Why does Cecil have that in the beginning and such? Who knows? It looked cool when you cast it, when he did it the first time, because it's like, wow, this guy knows some really powerful magic. Why can't he do that anymore?
If I remember right, the boss's area is weak to fire.
Nope.
Ah, okay.
Weak to lightning.
Then we will keep the fire in mind. Oh my god, frogs.
Welcome to the problem with this dungeon. If I remember right, though, not this floor, but the next floor actually has an upgrade to Cecil's equipment.
I believe you're right.
Cecil's going to go from hitting pretty hard to, holy crap, why do you hit so hard?
Oh, that's right. This is one of those 3D ones that changes your equipment. Changes mm-hmm. a maiden's kiss.
Yeah, if you notice, Radia's got a different looking rod in her hand now because it's all icy.
Yep. Yeah, she reflects the fact that it's a ice rod pretty well.
It's almost like we're playing Golden Sun or something like that.
What the? Wait, did Golden Sun actually do that?
I think so. Kind of. It reflected different weapon types that you were using, at least.
I have traversed the darkness.
Seriously, Cecil, stop scowling.
Oh, that's a big frog.
When you're in the darkness, you can go up and keep going up and all the way around, and you'll eventually get to a treasure.
Big frog has been dealt with.
The golden frog?
Yes. Iridia doesn't do as much damage single target as Tellah does AoE.
I might be wrong about this, but I think the spell cast from the rod does less damage than an actual spell.
That would make sense.
However, he does have almost double her intelligence. I think he actually does have double her intelligence.
Alright, I have removed myself from... Oh, god. Damn it! The back attack. Let's do an AoE Cura. It's a toger.
Mm-hmm. It's an ogre toad.
dumb name.
Listen, they can't all be winners, okay?
Alright, what did I get sent on a wild goose chase for?
Pretty sure it's a hat.
I'll take a hat. It's a feathered cap, in fact. We'll slap that on Rydia and then give Tellah the leather hat. Everybody goes up. What's Cecil thinking?
Still thinking that the Sage's spells are a huge help.
The only annoying thing about this is now I have to go back.
Mm-hmm.
Wish I could just run. And then, like, shit, like, preemptive strike. I'd be a fool not to just take advantage of this to get some extra experience.
At this point, you're pretty much set.
Should also save, yeah, should also save some MP for the boss.
Brady is not going to really learn any more spells that she needs. Cecil's as beefy as he needs to be. And Tellah's Tellah. He's not going to... He's already strong enough as is. A level's not going to do too much to change his damage output. He's already going to deal a lot.
Sorry. This fucking every time I get into a fight in the darkness.
You just spin and it's just kind of disorienting. Yeah.
Oh,
I,
no.
I had that...
You actually lose money for... Oh, wait. Did I actually need to traverse the darkness? Is dump me out up here with a cave exit.
It's also the cave exit is right there. But there's the... Okay, so the original map is there's... you can go into the bottom part and it'll connect you to the part where you're at, but it'll also connect all the way around. So there's a, like a E almost of darkness. That's how the connections are.
Yeah.
So you don't technically have to go through the darkness to get to the next level, but you need to go through the darkness if you're going to find that treasure chest.
Yeah, also the reward for that dungeon was very nice.
Yeah, the sweet 3 Phoenix Downs. Save yourself some money.
I'll run away from fights, but I won't turn down a preemptive strike.
That's fair.
Which right now is just a free win.
This is Tellah saying, and Blizzard.
Oh my god, this encounter rate is actually a bit much.
Yeah. That was one of the issues I had with the DS version.
Where's my super repel?
So, fun fact, I'm pretty sure if you get every single... map complete, the game gives you the super repel augment.
I believe you're actually right. I know how to deal with zombies.
Run away.
Cast AoE fire.
It's also an option.
Give Rydia one more good level.
The game was... another reason this game is kinder than the other one. In this game, if Cecil hits a zombie, it does a small amount of damage, but it's still some damage. In the original, he would deal 1 damage.
Huh.
Yeah.
I appreciate that in these fights when I try and run away, they always try and toad Cecil.
Yes. Again, I'm pretty sure it's an effect of his armor is that he just has a couple status effect resistances because he's wearing somewhat magical gear.
Alright, there's an item I can throw at the fish.
It's not a fish.
At the fish.
Okay.
Something for Cecil to do on his turn.
I actually think the thing is also weak to darkness.
Of course it is.
Well, that's actually something I think Tellah mentions, is the thing fears your sword.
I had a bigger sword.
Yes. Or at least a goofier looking one.
Cecil, you probably put the sword away as you're trying to run.
You'd be surprised how hard that would be to do.
I guess so, seeing as he doesn't actually have a sheath.
I think it's one of those magnetically attaches to my back things.
Yeah, weird that they had that this long ago.
Magic armor.
Ah, there it is, the Shadow Blade. Yeah, it's a good 10-point increase. It's alright.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay.
You know, not much.
It's alright. You can just walk right past it. Zombies.
Not only does it give you a 10-point increase to attack, it also boosts your accuracy.
Jeez, this guy's poisoned.
Well, you did have a dungeon upgrade, or at least a map finish that gave you antidotes.
True.
If you want to be an even bigger dick to the zombies, you can have telecast Cura on them.
Bronze Hourglass, I believe, is haste?
No, I'm pretty sure that's a stop type thing. Haste is Hermes Sandals.
Alright. And then Spider Silk is slow.
Yes. One thing you will learn in this game, a lot of enemies can be hit by a slow spell, and oh boy, does it help.
Yeah. I've read that. Pretty much like I said, I looked at a couple of boss fights when glancing through the guide. And pretty much every one of them was like, turn one, use Spider Silk.
Mm-hmm. That is something they carried over in the after years, because in that game, it's just turn one should be, you slow this boss or this boss wrecks you.
I'm just going to save.
Yeah.
I actually save, think my party's pretty fine. I don't think I need a tent.
Don't use a tent, that's cool too.
I'll have Rhea cast a Cura on the party. As soon as I figure out how to do that. Oh, you have to go down all the way. That's weird. Alright. Leap into the waterfall. Yeah, sure, why not?
Mm-hmm. Kind of makes you wonder how people get back.
I thought this went right in...
No, that's why I said you should use the tent.
I thought it went right into the boss fight. That's what they kind of made it seem like.
Nope.
That's...
It's okay. You have ethers.
Yeah. I'll be fine. Oh.
Oh man, jellies.
Jellies are extremely weak. Is it just one map? This dungeon is huge.
Yeah, there's two maps.
We've actually been over time for a while, but I figured keep going, finish the dungeon. But then the dungeon just keeps going.
Going. Going.
Oh, okay, you get all of Cecil's upgrades in this dungeon. Just optimize. I had a brief thought of maybe they'll just cast Toad on Rydia again. Fine, I'll cast Blizzard on you all.
You want to die so bad, that's fine.
Just trying to spare you, but I guess.
It's okay. Eventually you'll get an actual speedy character, and maybe this will get faster.
Maybe. Hopefully. Yeah, free Maiden's Kiss, and we'll just throw a couple potions on people. Save MP.
One thing I do like about the DS version is the random drop rate of items from enemies is increased quite a bit. In some cases, it's increased a bit too much, and you can get some very rare items well before you're supposed to. But hey, whatever. It's nice to get some items that turn characters like, say, Rosa, who's pretty good at what she does, into being, holy crap, why are you so good?
Wait,
based on items.
Like what?
Like, Rosa is an archer, but right. She's mostly a white mage. But you can actually, some enemies can drop excellent bows for her much, much earlier than you would expect. And it turns her from, like, an okay damage dealer into being almost as good as some of your frontliners.
I thought it might be something like that.
And there's also some other gear you can find that is equipable items for people like Cecil or also Kane that rapidly boost their strength by like 10, and you find it halfway through the game. So there's some stuff that you can find in this game if you look hard enough that can kind of break it even more than the game is supposed to be broken.
In retrospect, yeah, Cecil actually can't take a spell for shit.
No, his magic defense is shit.
Did I miss his shield?
No, you didn't. There is no shield.
Oh, okay. Crocodiles, actually, you're a new enemy. I'll kill you.
I believe the crocodiles are weak to ice.
We'll find out. You are correct. Also, Cecil just did, I think, like 180 damage.
New sword.
New sword is better than old sword. Seeker, I guess that's a bestiary thing. Ah, it was good to finish the map. I just got a bunch of Zeus's wraths.
Man, I wonder what that's for. That's what I was talking about, is some deep stuff, actually.
Octomammoth, you were never really scary looking.
Nope. I like the name better in the SNES version, which was Octomom. Look at that face.
Cecil assumes the fart cloud. Yeah, it might actually be better for Rydia to throw Zeus's wraths at it.
Yes. So, here's another thing that's different in the hard mode versus normal mode. You know, notice how that thing was hitting Cecil for like 10 damage there?
Yeah.
Multiply that by like 15.
Okay, I take back what I said about Zeus's wraths maybe being better than her normal damage.
Shrug.
Also, I thought you were going to say something like it attacks with each of its tentacles each turn.
No, it just hits much, much harder. Maybe not 15. It deals about 100 damage per hit. We're here dealing 20. Also, holy crap, Cecil, you hit like a truck.
Yeah, he's doing a lot of the heavy lifting in this fight.
This is the real reason Tellah wanted him along. Tellah probably figures he could have gotten through the cave on his own because, you know, lightning spam. But this boss, it'd be nice to have someone who hits like as hard as Cecil does.
So Cecil or Tellah just yelling out, "Ah, we've almost won, but not yet." Thanks, Tellah. Does the boss actually get like more attacks or anything, or is that just a lot of flavor text?
I think the boss is supposed to hit a little bit harder now. Yeah, the boss actually hits much harder now.
Okay. Oh yeah, that's significant, actually. I wasn't paying attention enough. What does the staff do if you use it as an item?
I think it's Asuna? I could be wrong about that one.
That would have been good to know earlier.
It could be something else instead. I actually don't use it that often.
Oh boy. Alright, we're using the last of your MP. And it's dead.
And it's dead.
The hotel was on his last limbs, last legs.
Yeah. That. It hits pretty hard.
That's a lot of experience.
Yeah. The bosses are harder in this game, and they are much more generous with how much. Or how big of a reward they give out.
The 6-year-old can bring the dead back.
Yeah. Gained 2 levels, and in the process, wow.
Just became aware of, like, I don't think Rydia's, hold up, we'll switch characters. Yeah, Rydia's mouth is below the water level.
Well, she's like 6 years old, man.
I know, but just like, I guess take a deep breath.
Her mouth is, but her nose is just above, so she's fine.
I'm gonna split a video.